Hi everyone, so I'm here with my best friend in the whole world, Sunny. She's 169XO on Instagram. All the links down below. Definitely check her out because we are together all the time. Give her a follow.
Hit me up.
So this video we've kind of like dreaded to film because we don't really want to start some wars or start some dramas, but literally we have received this ever since we became friends. We've had the question, how did you guys become friends? How did you guys meet? And this is a very interesting
story.
I love this story because the people that I tell it to, they're like,
whoa.
They're like, whoa, Sunny's that person.
And I'm
like,
me.
Yes, that was Sunny. For those who haven't watched this Gertrude video, I'm gonna put it in the corner here. Basically, what that video was, for me to sum it up, for those who don't really want to watch it, I don't even want to watch it myself.
I watched it twice last year.
You watched it twice? Really? For me, it's just like, I sound different. Like, I'm obviously visibly upset, hurt, and angry about it. I feel like I filmed it too quickly. But also, for those who are doubting that it's real, this girl, Gertrude, had also sent me this 2-page long apology, which I'm gonna flash on the screen here. For those who don't know, I had forgiven her after 2 years that this had happened. So, I, like, genuinely forgiven her. But let's just go into what happened in that video. So, basically, in that video, I had a housemate who became my closest friend, and she was she had a lot of rage and anger issues, to say the least, and she had doxed me online. She had posted some stuff on Facebook about trying to find my location, bash me, blah blah blah.
Next level
stuff. And it was all because I told her that she was a toxic friend and I wanted to distance myself from her. She did what any toxic friend would do.
That's relatable now.
Right? Like, she did what any toxic friend would do and just like blasted me online. At this point, I had only lived in Australia for 6 months, so I was completely new here. I was in a house by myself, and I was getting all these nasty messages and comments from people saying they were gonna try look for me, bash me. And note that I was 18 years old. This woman is four or five.
She's pretty older than us.
Yeah, she's older than you. Yeah. So she was a lot older than me, and I had just turned 18, and I moved to a city I've never been to. Like, I didn't know what she could have done. Like, either way, she was calling me every day. This one time I answered on the train and she screamed at me like, I'm gonna rip off your fucking head, like all this stuff.
I'm gonna take your skull.
Yeah. She was saying some really fucking crazy shit, and I had hung up the phone and I had an anxiety attack on the train. So I started panicking, and the man next to me said to me, get off the next train station and walk this way. There's a police station.
What a beautiful man. You need
to report this. Anyways, so I get to the police station. I say to them, like, I don't want to charge her. Like, I just wanted them to call her and be like, look, this 18-year-old young girl is visibly scared, visibly upset. Could you please stop harassing her? Stop messaging her. Stop calling her on different numbers. That's all I wanted from the police. They sat me down in a different room, got all her details down, and I kept saying to him, all I want you to do is just call her back and be like, look, she's at the police station. And while I was at the police station, I got a text message, and the text message was more screenshots of this girl trying to get my address, trying to find me so she could hit me, bash me, all of the above. And she was trying to gather people to come together to do it as well. And with these screenshots, I did not have, because I had blocked her on Facebook and all this social media. So I got this message from a random number with all the screenshots, because at this point I'm like crying. I show him my phone and he sees those messages and what she was posting, and he said, okay, you know what, this is enough to charge her with, I don't remember what it was specifically, but gathering people together to cause harm to someone, as well as like harassment and like doxing. I don't remember, he listed a bunch of things to me, and at this point I'm just like crying, and he's taking photos of my phone that received the messages. He's taking every single screenshot, and like the whole way through I'm having an anxiety attack. He tells me, like, you gotta go file a restraining order because this is not okay. When I get back home, I reply to this number that had sent me all those screenshots, and I say, hey, thank you so much, what's your name, what's your Instagram? So Sunny replied and texted me back, this is my Instagram, this is my Facebook, like, add me. I said to her, thank you so much, because of you, like, I was able to get the police to help me, because they didn't even want to call her and tell her to stop. So that's all I wanted, but they weren't gonna do anything. Until I got those messages, that's when they actually, like, started to take it seriously. Mm. She had messaged me at the right time.
I'm a guardian angel.
Like, that's honestly how I felt about you. Now, from your perspective, like what made you wanna message me? Because she got my number because this Gertrude person put my number out online to all my followers and friends.
Well, I was friends with Gert.
Gert?
On Facebook.
Go on.
And I'm away from high school. She crazy, man. She freaking crazy. And I've had an experience with this crazy girl. And I saw this fucking status. I mean, whoops, beep. And I was like, oh my God, I gotta save this little person. She said like your full name or something. So I'm like, I'm just gonna go on Instagram and have a look. And I was like, this girl's so cool. Why would you be so mean? So I was like, you know what? Fuck everyone. I'm just gonna send this message to her. Send it!
So I added her on Facebook. We were friends on Instagram. And
for many years, though.
And for 2 years or 2.5 years, we had just liked each other's photos.
We had shit in common, like not eating meat,
Oh, I remember that now. Oh, that just triggered that moment. Yeah. But yeah, we were just tagging each other in memes. Never really talked like one-on-one. And then I posted on Instagram, I think it was, and I was like, hey, I'm looking for friends who are vegetarian, that are artistic, that like to do art days, friends that like to travel. Mm. I just like kind of like made a list of like what type of friend I was looking for.
Ticking all the boxes.
And I think the main one was like, I'm looking for like a vegetarian friend. Mm. Of course, the people I was with, they didn't really understand like my lifestyle choices. When Sunny had hit me up and she was like, look, I'm a vegetarian. Like I like to travel.
I hate
everything. Like I live in Bali. You're like, I'm very open-minded. Mm. Like I like to do art days. I like to draw. I like Jersey Shore or whatever. I don't even remember specifically what it was. As soon as she hit me up, she was like, be my friend. I was like, hell yeah, bitch. We had already been friends on Instagram and Facebook for a while.
We gotta get a little video, put it here soon, of the first time we met when I ran at you.
Yay! Okay, it's right here. Okay, a few months before I had met her in person, I got the apology from Gertrude, and the apology, I honestly believed her. I thought it was a genuine apology, and to this day, like, I actually do forgive her for what she had done. And so I started hanging out with Gertrude again to like rebuild or at least like make things civil, and it was very easy to do because I didn't realize how much she was lying to me. But anyway, we'll get to that later. So I had planned this Bali trip with a friend. The friend couldn't actually make it. And I knew that Sunny was living in Bali. And I had visited Bali twice beforehand. And I had messaged her and I was like, let's hang out or something. But because of like funds or whatever reason, like we're getting busy. Like we never got to actually like hang out. When she'd come to Perth, I'd be like, you're in Perth?
I'm in Boston already.
Let's hang out. And then she'd be like, oh, I was in Perth last night, but I'm in Busselton now, which is like
10 years that way.
two hours away because that's where her family lives. Mm. And every time like we were in the same country, we try to meet up and it just never worked out. But I think there's a reason for it.
Like, yeah,
I think
there's a reason for it.
Honestly, there's a reason.
You came into my life the perfect
man. Like, when we met, it was the perfect time. A few days before I go to Bali, and I had already hit you up and I was like, I'm gonna be hanging out with you. This is what we're doing. We're gonna get our nails done. We're gonna go shopping. Like, we had all these plans. We were sending voice memos. Like, the thing about it is that I had never heard your voice until 2 days before I had left. And I remember saying, like, oh, it's so good to hear your voice because you could have been a 40-year-old.
I could have been anyone, man.
You could have been some 40-year-old man. But anyways, 2 days before I left, I had lunch with Gertrude. And Gertrude was like, oh, how do you know Sunny? And I said to her, I was like, oh, actually, remember when you doxed me online and you put my number and contacts and all that for everyone to see? Sunny's the one who sent me all of those screenshots because she knew what I was talking about. She admitted that she watched the video where I made about Gertrude, so about her. And she was like, fuck that bitch! She's like,
I'm gonna take her skull this time!
Wait, let me think what she says.
She's not even my friend, like, but she's a fucking traitor!
Literally, like, calling her a traitor, like, scummy. Like, started getting really mad about it. This girl has rage issues. And this is the first time I've ever, like, even yelled back at her. And I, like, slammed my hand on the table, and I was like, don't you dare say anything because you admitted you were wrong, and if you have an issue with someone calling you out for doing something wrong, then you don't realize what you did was wrong. She shut up real quick. It took me like, what, 10 seconds to say it, but it was along the lines of like, if you have an issue with someone calling you out for you doing something wrong, you don't believe that you did something wrong. I realized to this day that she still didn't believe what she did was wrong, putting my personal details out. Even living like in the house with her, all the situations that happened, she did not believe it was wrong. And we went on with our day and did not mention it whatsoever. I go to Bali. I meet Sunny. Yep, here's the video of
us. Yeah, here meeting. It is. That's us meeting.
We click like this. Right? Like,
I didn't even meet you and I ran towards you. You could have had a gun.
Yeah, like, really.
What the fuck? Sure.
As soon as we met, we just realized how many similarities we
had.
And
you bought me lush.
Yeah, I brought you a ton of gifts. Yeah. The first place you took me to eat is my favorite place to eat in Bali. After, like, the first day of hanging out.
I, like, moved into your hotel, even though I had a house.
You moved into my hotel. You moved into my hotel. And the first night we fell asleep, I was cuddling you and she wakes up because I'm cuddling her.
And I'm
her.
Like, oh, there's an earthquake.
And I'm like, there's an earthquake. And then we run downstairs and we're like,
and then no one gives a fuck. And
like I have met her for 2 days and we are telling each other we love each other.
We are sharing a wallet, man. Well,
yeah, the whole trip, we shared a wallet. Everything we did was like
we are doing this.
You know, and honestly, there's like no person in the world that I clicked so easily with you. Like the only way I can describe it is that we were friends in the past life. Even when I think about like how we met, I think about like all the times where we could have met up in Perth,
but
like where we could have met up in Bali. Like the time that I went to see you in Bali was the time where we both like needed each other.
I needed someone, like, and you just came.
Needed someone, and I needed someone, and we both like found each other. It's like a magical experience.
I'm gonna get emotional.
Yes. So
I'm gonna get full
So right after my short 12-day Bali trip, I had already been like living at her house. Like I thought that when I was moving back to Perth, that I wasn't gonna see her for many months. So I fucking bawled, crying in the airport. I was like, you were the best. And I'm like, ever happened.
Y'all gotta calm down.
Yeah, I've never met someone like you before.
You're like kind of ventilating.
Yeah, I was like, I'm crying now, like thinking about the way I felt, because the way I felt was like I was getting ripped apart from my soulmate.
Oh, I had to go home like, to an empty house.
Oh my god, yeah, I'm like gonna start crying. Like I honestly felt like I was ripped apart from my soulmate because I had to leave. Like you were literally my soulmate. When I arrived in Perth, she had called me and she said, I hate how empty the house is. I've booked a flight home. I think we lived together in total for about 7 or 8 months. It didn't feel that long.
Nah, it felt
like a minute.
I know.
Like, it felt like a minute. When I think about it, like I can't even believe that you and I squeezed in that tiny room. She had moved into this big room and then, you know, we both got into relationships, our separate relationships. So she moved in with her boyfriend. My boyfriend moved in here. We still see each other
every second day. I have a key for this house, dude.
Yeah, of course you do. And to the point where like, if there's one person I can be absolutely myself to, it is you. And I hope you feel the same way.
We're gonna be in wheelchairs one day, old. Yep. Zooming around,
fucking racing each
Putting
other.
Putting our eyeliner on still.
So with the update with Gertrude, she had moved in with my two other friends, and I hadn't told those girls about what Gertrude had done to me when I lived with her and what happened. I didn't want them to act differently towards Gertrude. And so
it was
the only time I mentioned it was like I had hung out with one of the housemates for the whole day and she had brought it up and I said to her before I even talked about it, I said, I didn't want to tell you this because I don't want you to treat her differently. Don't want to start drama, blah, blah, blah. And I had told her what happened in the whole Gertrude situation and she was like, that's fucked up. And she told me the version Gertrude told them, which was completely different, and I had already started to get the inkling that Gertrude was talking bad about me to my own friends, and so they ended up leaving and being on bad terms with Gertrude. Because of that as well, I have distanced myself from Gertrude on top of like me dating my boyfriend.
That's gonna be another part three, Gertrude.
That's another story. So I'm gonna be perfectly honest, I actually don't have any like hate towards Gertrude.
I didn't give
Gertrude.
A fuck. If she came up and waved at me, I'd wave
like,
back.
If she, like, we all believe that, like, maybe not my boyfriend, but like, if she had come up to us and seen us in the city and said hi, like, we would have been like, we would have been like, hey, what the hell? It's so weird seeing you, you know what I mean? Of course, I hate like the way she treated my friends, but I believe my friends and all that stuff, but like, I also know that like, there's always two sides of the story, there's always like, like someone going through something and that's the reason why they lash out and stuff like that. And because I do understand her mental disorder, it makes me be a bit more forgiving towards her, and that's why I'm like, I'm not hateful towards her. I don't want this video to be like, oh fuck Gertrude. It's more so thank you, like, because of you I have the bestest friend in my life, because of you I have my boyfriend who's amazing.
Part three.
And so part three, guys, fucking watch it. So if she is watching this for the chance, like, we honestly, we have no ill towards you. Of course it was weird when you saw us three out in public and you started kicking a stink.
Did a little bit noise.
But like, we would never yell bad things at you the way you did to us. Like, we wouldn't retaliate. Like,
we'd just say hello.
To the point where, like, if she wants to message us, if she wants to hit me up, I would talk to her as a human being. So many people in my life, when I brought her back into my life after she sent me that apology and I forgave her, so many people in my life were like, why did you do that? She's always done this. She's just like manipulating you, lying to you. I still stood by her and I was like, let the past be the past. Yeah, definitely she is like a fun person to talk about just because of like how angry she gets over like little things. It's been a year we've been trying to film this and we were like, we don't want to start any type of like drama with Gertrude.
It's just a video.
But like, we can't talk about how we became friends.
Without that part.
Without that part. Without us saying that the first time I heard from you, I was at the police station having a panic attack because this girl was doxing me online. Like, how, I don't know how to talk about this story without mentioning that Gertrude situation. Like,
so
again,
we mentioned it.
It's
it is what it is.
So
Gertrude, if you're watching, we Gucci.
We Gucci. Whatever. Honestly, we Gucci. Like, fucking hit us up. Like, we
don't care. We
to,
Gucci. Like, we can bloody get a coffee and drink coffee. Ew.
You said to me, you were like, if she had just like said hi, like we would.
I would have just like, been like, hi.
Actually, yes. Yeah, like, what else would we?
I don't know.
Do? Like, what? We would just start yelling at each other at
like,
a shopping mall.
I'm not doing that. I'm not about that.
You know, we are in a shopping mall, and you are a 26 or 20,
whatever you
26
are.
Year old. Woman, like, what?
We would have just said hi.
Like, we literally would have just said hi. Like, it wouldn't be like, oh my god, hey! But it would be like, oh my god, that's weird seeing you. That's what it would have been. It wouldn't have been anything else. Yeah, so that's our story. When I think about how much panic and anxiety I had at the time with the whole Gertrude situation, now when I look back, it was all worth it because I had, like, depended on you, and because of that, like, we were comfortable with each other. Or at least I was comfortable to talk to you online. Like, we came into each other's lives at the right time where we both were like transforming, evolving as people, and we both could do that together.
Yeah, we both like, I don't know what I'm saying.
Why do you still have that skull? Oh, because she was like I want to have her skull on my bedside table.
I think Chris made this.
Chris made it, yeah.
Chris made this. I didn't.
I think it's really cool. But yeah, thank you guys for watching this video. Make sure to check out Sunny on Instagram. She's 169XO on Instagram, and check me out as well too. It's universal.hobo. Right. You will find her through my Instagram. She's all
You'll find
my
her through
Instagram.
Mine. Follow whatever you want.
And the question I have for you guys today is, do you think Sunny should start a YouTube channel? She didn't let me ask.
I don't know where this is coming from.
She has no idea where this is coming from, but I honestly think Sunny is such a funny person and she would do fucking great on YouTube. Thank you guys. Is there anything you want to say before we go?
Yeah.
Love you guys so much. Bye.
Bye.